Hi everyone. So what we're going to do today is we're going to pick up with where we left off yesterday, and we're going to have a little look at direct democracy. We're going to look at the advantages and disadvantages of direct democracy. So direct democracy, just to remind you, is we see it in the United Kingdom through referendums where people decide decisions for themselves. So firstly, the advantages of referendums. So just mentioned the first advantage, it is the purest form of democracy, where individuals, where citizens make decisions for themselves. So basically there are a number of issues. So the referendum on EU membership in 2016 is a classical example of this. There are examples where the views that are held by our representatives, by our politicians, aren't the same as those held by the people. We see this in the EU referendum. The majority of politicians wanted to remain part of the European Union, but the British people, very narrowly, wanted to leave the European Union. So it's people genuinely making political decisions. That's the first advantage. The second advantage is that it encourages political participation, encourages full participation. So again, we can see this through the turnout in elections. In that EU referendum, which I just spoke about, there was a 72% turnout. If we look at the Scottish independence referendum in 2014, there was an 84% turnout. Compare that to the turnout in the most recent general election in December 2019. That was just 67%. So the encouragement of political participation is the second advantage. The third advantage is that decisions have greater legitimacy because they have the consent of the people. And what we now have in the United Kingdom is every time there is a major decision that is being made, such as leaving the EU, Scottish independence, changing the electoral system, opening devolved bodies, the governments accept that they need greater legitimacy for those decisions, so they call a referendum. So those are the advantages. The disadvantages, so in the words of John Stuart Mill, it can lead to a tyranny of the majority. And what this means is really the views of many minorities can be underrepresented. So we can see this with the fact that for a long time, women's views weren't acknowledged, weren't accepted. Women's issues weren't really considered by politicians until women got the vote, and then women could influence the decision making process. If you have a winner takes all system whereby the majority benefit from something and the minority don't, then minority views can be underrepresented if we wield out referendums on a grander scale. The second issue is a big one, it's the major one. So the majority view is not always the right view. So just because a majority of people believe something doesn't make it right. It doesn't make it the most informed viewpoint. So critics of that 2016 EU referendum would say a lot of people didn't understand the full implications of leaving the European Union, and therefore it was wrong that you asked people who were perhaps a little bit ill-informed to vote on that issue. And the final point is that we elect representatives to make our decisions. We're letting them off the hook if we make decisions on their behalf. So part of the job of a politician is to make perhaps unpopular decisions, to make difficult decisions, not to turn around in the most difficult issues which they may face and say, you decide it for me. So those are the advantages and disadvantages of direct democracy. I'll be in touch soon with the advantages and disadvantages of representative democracy. Take care.